Hello, this is Chuck Ridgway, Automation Technology Manager at Horner. Thanks for joining us for another Tuesday live stream. Well, I'm here from the WEFTECH show in New Orleans, Louisiana. If you're curious about what's going on at WEFTECH this week, or you're curious about who is Horner Automation, we have a short video that our marketing staff put together. Let's take a look at that right now. So we've got a lot planned for you today. We've got three products we're going to be showing off. One that's established but has a new feature that's been added to it. We have a second one that we'll be showing you that is approaching release status here at the beginning of next year. And we have a third one that we're showing off for the first time ever at a trade show. But before we get to those products and maybe a tour of the booth, we thought you'd be interested in taking a look at how we set up the booth over the weekend. You might be surprised to learn that it only took about a minute or so. Okay, let's take a look down that main aisle here at WEFTECH at the New Orleans Convention Center. We'll be taking a tour of the Horner booth next. Let's get started. Starting on our main left rack, We've got the OCS 360 demonstration. We'll go into that later. Followed by Canvas in the center, a popular new all-in-one controller series that we released back in the summer. And then our CPU series, which we will be launching next year, along with plug-and-play displays that you see along the left side of the rack. So that's the left side of our booth. Now on the right side, in that rack, we have the Micro OCS, our entry-level series, followed by the XL15 Prime, our largest all-in-one controller, and then at the bottom, we've got our Horner Solution chart recorder. At the front of the booth, we have our Canvas 5D connected to our Wi-Fi adapter. It's compatible with any Horner OCS with a full-size USB port. It's a great way of adding Wi-Fi to any Canvas or Prime OCS. A brand new product that we're previewing for the first time anywhere this week is something that is called Bolo. It's beacon-oriented LoRa, and it's a new wireless communication solution from Horner. So again, we're previewing it for the first time ever here at the show, and we want to teach you a little bit about LoRa. Let's take a look. LoRa is a 900 megahertz wireless transmission standard designed for long distances and lower bandwidth. LoRa is great at rejecting interference, offering a robust network link even in the noisiest of environments. In the Horner LoRa implementation, one wireless radio acts as a beacon. The beacon connects to the Horner controller and is the hub of all wireless communications. Other LoRa radios are installed in remote I/O nodes, allowing them to interface with sensors and actuators and communicate back to the controller through the LoRa beacon. Now let's take a look at a beacon and an I/O node in action at WEFTEC. Okay, here's the LoRa beacon, which acts as the hub of all wireless communications and is connected directly to the Horner controller. We call the Horner wireless system Bolo because it is a beacon-oriented LoRa. Next is the wireless I/O node. This one is battery operated and features a small solar panel. It interfaces with the I/O, in this case, just a switch box for demonstration purposes, simulating sensors. Now let's head back to the beacon, this time also showing the micro OCS that the beacon is connected to. The beacon will receive wireless messages from the remote I/O, and the results will be displayed on the screen. If we go back to the remote I/O node and flip the switch, a few seconds later, we'll see the result on the micro OCS. Non-instantaneous updates are just fine. Remember, this isn't real-time control. This is monitoring where a few seconds is plenty fast enough. One of the new products that we're showing this week that's approaching release, we'll have a public beta here coming up in a month or so with full release around the first of the year, and that is our OCS 360 cloud service. Now with OCS 360, there's a lot of functionality there. You have data collection, you have advanced data analysis, you have alarming, and you have visualization, all included in the cloud service. So let's take a look and learn about OCS 360. So we have here at the show, we have this XLW Prime pushing data to OCS 360 to the cloud. And then over here, we're monitoring the data from the cloud. So everything's live. Okay, let's dive into the demonstration project that we're showing here at WEFTEC. We've got a couple of controllers that are simulating, you know, their locations at a couple of different water treatment facilities. Here's an overview of the facility, and we can look at individual elements at the facility. In this case, we've got a clarifier with a switch control. We've also got a speed control that we're exercising here, along with feedback, as you can see in the other objects there on the screen, widgets, if you will. So in addition to the ability to control here with the clarifier, let's go back to kind of the main screen and let's dive into the flow this time. No, let's not do that. Let's go take a look at the pump station tank level. You can see some additional controls here. And as you can see, there's graphics that's been imported into the back to offer, obviously, a sense of realism for the operator so they know what they're dealing with here. Let's go back one more time to the main screen. And this time, let's take a look at the digester level. So again, some nice graphics here with these widgets that allow you to monitor what's happening at the plant. Okay, so that's just a quick look at some of the visualization tools and visualization results that you can achieve with OCS 360. Again, we're getting close to the public beta period for this new cloud service. If you're interested in participating in the public beta, we'd love to talk to you about that. All right, and last but not least, the final product I'm going to talk to you about today that we're highlighting at WEFTEC. Unlike some of the others that I've talked about, this product is fully available. That's our digital chart recorder from Horner Solutions, and that is a chart recorder which allows you to display up to 4 analog values on the screen. Of course, they can be completely scaled to engineering units. Not only are they displayed on the screen, but they're also logged electronically. And again, the whole point here is to replace those paper chart recorders that you may have in your facility. Now, in terms of what's new with the chart recorder for 2024, we're getting ready to add the ability to add flow calculations to the chart recorder. So not only will you have 4 analog inputs, but you'll have flow capability as well. Okay, that's it from the WEFTEC show. Until next week, let's all get out there and eat some gumbo.